blesse mon cœur d'une langueur monotone. Je répète, blesse mon cœur d'une langueur monotone.
Hey everybody, dutchsinse here. It is 6:40 p.m. Central Time on the 22nd of December, 2018. It is Saturday night here in the United States, going into Sunday internationally. I've got some breaking bad news for everybody, guys. A very large blast and tsunami has occurred in the West Pacific over here, right where our two rings overlap at Mount Krakatau, a 50,000 foot high blast, hundreds of people killed, and large tsunami generated at the location just within the last hour. Now, this says 20 dead. Well, we can definitely have that now raised up. I saw just a headline listing the possible hundreds dead and hundreds injured. So we can go over to any one of these sites. We could go over to Twitter. That would probably be our best bet at this point to see what's going on. So you can see right here, for instance, 9 News in Denver has shots of an incoming wave. And here's Mount Krakatau. And to understand, Mount Krakatau is the son of Krakatoa. So son of Krakatoa is the leftover remnants from the famous blast heard around the world at Mount Krakatau. Now, this is completely unexpected. Look at the sudden blast. Well, the sudden wave, I mean. The sudden incoming wave from the blast. Now, there's no earthquake reported here yet. And I think the USGS probably is remiss on not reporting an earthquake associated with a 50,000-foot-high blast. Now, we can go over here. They have it at 550. This is going up into the stratosphere. And stratosphere begins roughly at this level, just a little bit below it. So this is a big enough blast that it should travel many hundreds to maybe even a few thousand miles in whichever way the greater jet stream is prevailing at this moment. Now, we need to talk about what we issued the warning for this week. We issued a warning right here in Sumatra, Indonesia, for the potential of an extremely large earthquake to strike. And this is day 6 of the 7-day warning for this location. Now, I made note of the overlapping earthquakes that overlap this area. And that's why we issued this warning this last week with all the deep earthquakes nearby. Now we have a large tsunami, an extremely large blast from Krakatau. That is huge for Mount Krakatau, which normally puts off 5,000-foot-high blasts. Maybe 10,000 foot at the most is what we've been seeing. Now we need to talk about Mount Krakatau. It came to life within the last year, and before that, we saw hardly any eruptions from Mount Krakatau for a long time. We have to go back to 2011 when Krakatau was going off with significant 5 and 10,000 foot high blasts. Well, now here we are with a 50,000 foot, 55,000 foot high blast. And here, where the other two rings overlap, Mount Sinabung stopped erupting back in June, which is highly abnormal in its own right. So Mount Sinabung would normally erupt at least once every few weeks, and it stopped erupting on June 20th. When it stopped erupting, back behind it, here at Krakatau, here at Mount Kerinci next to Krakatau, over here at Mount Agung, and back over to the east in eastern Indonesia, all these volcanoes started to show extreme increase in activity. Then our big 7.0 earthquakes and tsunami hit over here about a month and a half ago. So now here we are. If you're just now tuning in, the largest blast in, I would say, years or more here at Mount Krakatau has occurred, and it generated a tsunami in which we have now reports of dozens, scores of people killed and hundreds injured. So we're going to have to go through. Let's go and look at our latest posts and hit play. This is coming from YouTube.
Allahu Akbar, air. Air laut, naik. DLT, Grand LT ke Krakatawa.
That's when you're making your way out of there, guy. That's when you're not hanging around to find out whether or not there's a bigger wave coming in or not. That's when you're making your way to the second story or greater. But that may be as high as it went. Gonna have to tell you though, guys, that is right on the shoreline. That would be expected if there's a large blast. You gotta understand what's going on here. Let me go over to Western Sumatra, Indonesia, or Western Java, Sumatra. This is Sumatra, this is Java. And right down here in the middle, here is Mount Krakatau. And you see this? This is the leftover remnants of Mount Krakatoa, which used to be here, and it blew up 150, 200 years ago. And when it did, or maybe even longer, don't know the date on that, but when that happened, let's see, 1883. All right, okay, so that's pretty interesting, right? 1883 eruption that was heard around the world. It was a blast that sent a shockwave that quite literally was heard by people around the planet. So that's how big, and of course it caused a massive tsunami to be generated when the blast occurred and blew apart the island. Now, was it heard all the way around the world? I don't know, but it certainly was heard thousands of miles away. So here we are, largest blast, and we can certainly say years at the location, at Mount Krakatau, then generating a tsunami to spread out from this location. Our warned area was encompassing Mount Krakatau across Sumatra into Western Java as our warned spot for this week to keep watch. Now, what were we looking for? We were looking for an upper 6 to near 7.0 earthquake. What do you think a 55,000-foot-high blast and tsunami is equal to? Definitely equal to a upper 6 to near 7.0 earthquake. It's a direct earthquake forecast hit where the two rings overlap. Where the two rings of the two previous earthquakes on either side overlap is called the fulcrum point. I want you to think of this like a two-arm scale. With on one side we've got an arm, and on the other side we've got an arm, and in the middle is the fulcrum where the two arms rest. Now you apply a bunch of weight on one side and a bunch of weight on the other, and the cumulative total tallies up in the middle at the center of the scale and balances out. Well, in this case, we've got major activity on one side, and on the other side we have minimal activity, or a spread of fours. But you got to remember, we had a 5.8, 6.0 down here last night, which they downgraded, and a 5.8 down here in Australia. So two sixes on one side, and two sixes on the other, and a bunch of deep earthquakes. That's what we're dealing with here. That's what's happened over the past several days. So now, we're dealing with a 55,000-foot-high blast and tsunami, following the 7.4 that just hit a day ago up here off the coast of Kamchatka, going into Alaska, and that itself follows the 7 that struck up here in Anchorage that caused so much damage. So when we jump back over here one more time, if you're just now tuning in, a large volcanic blast has occurred over here at the straits in between Sumatra and Java at Mount Krakatau, 55,000-foot-high blast. And let's jump back over to Twitter and see where there's a tsunami generated, dozens of people killed, and many people injured by an unexpected wave off of this. So far, 20 dead, 165 injured. Oh boy, terrible tsunami. It's in foreign languages, of course. We have pictures. Man. Bad news, guys. Bad news. It was a big wave, apparently, in some spots. The video that's being captured by the restaurant obviously is not representative of the greater size wave that came in and caused. Look at what happened here. Again, this is nighttime footage. This is a perfect example of seismic unrest translating into volcanic activity. Now, we can talk about volcanoes and how 20 different volcanoes this past week popped off around the plate, 20 separate volcanoes that were putting off ash advisories. This is on top of just normal lava flows and normal eruptions. We're talking about multi-1,000-foot-high ash advisories. And when we have 20 different volcanoes, we can even add in Mount Cleveland and Veniaminoff up here in Alaska that went. I can name them off for you. Let's do that. Veniaminoff in Alaska, as well as Cleveland, going over to the west, Chivalush, and Ebiko both went. Down to the south, Sakurajima and Kuchina Arabajima side by side both went. Go down to the south even more, Mount Mayon went in central Philippines. Further down to the south, Mount Ibu, Mount Tucono, and Mount Soputan, all three side by side, went here in North Indonesia. Mount Manam sent off a 45,000 foot high blast this past week over in eastern Papua New Guinea. And Mount Ambrum went here at the mouth of Vanuatu. Then over to the west, we have the big blast that just happened here at Mount Krakatau. That's just over in the West Pacific. And then to complete out the list of 20 volcanoes, we go down here and we have Popocatépetl, which erupted. Also, Santa Guido and Fuego in Guatemala, which erupted. We have Turrialba, which erupted. We had Nevados del Ruiz, which erupted in Colombia. We had Reventador and Sanjay, which erupted here in Ecuador. Today, Santiago volcano erupting out here in Galapagos, very rare. And then down to the south, Sabancaya erupting in South Peru, Planchon Petaroa, and Nevados de Chilean both erupting in Chile. I mean, come on. That is a lot of volcanic activity to see. And then now to get this with a tsunami attached to it, we're talking about big time blast and most likely underwater landslide associated with the blast. When it's been decades since you've seen anything that big at this volcano, and it is located out here in the middle of the strait, and you have steep cliff sides. So here, let's talk about the depth here. This goes from right at sea level, which of course is sea level, 0 foot. Then we drop off and we go down to about 400 feet. So if you think about it that way, if there's a landslide that happens in here, well, it could be at least a couple hundred feet high that gets displaced. And that would then shoot out at a very rapid speed, at the speed of the landslide, and go out over to the east or to the north or south or whichever way the landslide took place. Now, if there's a blast on top of it that puts out ejectile, and then that goes, of course, crashing into the water, that too can cause, well, bigger than a splash. You would talk about a giant wave. Now, I have questions about which way the wave went on this. We can go over and take a look at the National Data Buoy Center. This is the fifth time I've had to consult the National Data Buoy Center in the last 3 weeks for tsunami activity to see if there is any or not. Okay, in Western Indonesia, we are remiss. Look at what we're missing. Oh my goodness, look. They've got coverage going up to Myanmar in the Indian Ocean, but they don't have buoy coverage in the most seismically prone area on the planet. Oh man. Okay, so our nearest buoy is far over to the east, not showing anything yet. That's within the last hour. No other movement on the other buoys around the plate. We would see them flashing if they were. So we don't have any movement, but we also don't have any buoys over there to see if there's any movement. Absolutely, positively a scientific disaster in this 21st century. We don't have coverage here right on the coast of Indonesia for buoys. Okay. All right. Well, let's jump back in if you're just now tuning in. The largest blast in years has happened over here at Mount Krakatau, which is the son of Krakatoa. You've all heard of Krakatoa before. We all learned it in the history books. Blue sky high back in the 1800s. Well, now here we are, and we're blue sky high, stratospheric high, with a 55,000 foot high blast and scores of people killed and hundreds injured, at least, with a tsunami that was generated. So let's go back over to Twitter and just search again. I'll do a real-time search here for us. Indonesia tsunami. There we are, and we're going to just do a latest search. Look at the shots coming in on this. Look at, I mean, we're talking devastated damage, guys. So whatever that the wave that came in, if we do get video of the actual wave which came in, I wonder if this is it. Again, we don't know. This could be Japan for all we know. But we'll wait to see if the footage comes in of the actual large wave that could be generated off this. I mean, it was clearly devastating. The only question is, how big was it at the nearest closest epicenter to the blast of the volcano. Mount Krakatau, nothing to play around with, but it normally only goes in the few thousand foot high range, 3,000, 5,000, maybe 10,000 feet on a big blast. So to see it at 55,000 feet, stratospheric high, and to have that big of a wave generated means we're dealing with a major event. Now, if you guys want to, you can go over to my YouTube channel, go back to Sunday night, go listen to my forecast for this week. We issued a very specific warning for this location here in the West Pacific to be on watch for an upper 6 to near 7.0 earthquake to strike right here. And what hit? Well, now we have the biggest blast in years, a tsunami and scores of people killed. And this is directly in the middle of the warned area. So we warn the people in Indonesia, guys, if it comes in as a large blast as opposed to a large earthquake and a tsunami is still generated, I do consider that an earthquake forecast hit. I know that's not going to matter for many people. I know a lot of people over here were ready and paying attention. Now, do you have a quick tsunami plan? When that happens, when that blast happened, it wasn't registered as an earthquake, but I guarantee you the people around the location felt that event. So there was some seismic activity that had to be related with this blast because it's so big. So one more time, if you're just now tuning in, the biggest blast in years or more, maybe even decades, has struck over here at Mount Krakatau, the son of Krakatoa. Of course, the same location, just Krakatoa blew apart back in the 1800s, and all that's left are the three surrounding islands and the volcano in the middle. So now it is on in the West Pacific. This is what we call seismic go time, and it's all based upon the deep earthquakes that we've been having. This is, again, now we're dealing with a 7.4, a 55,000 foot high blast, the 7.4 up here in the North Pacific, and the 55,000 foot high blast here in the West Pacific with tsunami means that we have to watch the rest of the Pacific, the other two portions at least, east and south, for compensation to occur. So this is a big deal. We are here in December. Need I remind everybody what happened a few Decembers ago and going back? Well, now I think it's sealed deal here that December seems to be a time when we see major increase in seismic activity. We saw this happen in 2016. We saw this happen back in 2014. We even saw this happen as far back as Boxing Day, back when the big earthquakes hit over here at Sumatra, Indonesia. Now, some people ask me, is that timed with the solstice? Well, I would say more with the tilt of the earth, that if we're going to talk about the perturbance of the interior of the planet, that there could be a point where there's a perturbance. Now, we are also just passing the full moon aspect, but full moon, I don't want to play that in, at least not yet, but it's just worthy to note that that's going on as well. And one final thing I'd like everybody to pay attention to is something that I showed you guys in last night's update, which we're going to go over and look again, and I showed it to you today as well, the Bureau of Meteorology. Now, this is coming from Australia. We're going to look at the magnetosphere, and you're going to watch this thing, and we're going to look and see how it bounced around all day today. So watch this, and this is the magnetosphere around the Earth, the magnetopause. Now, this is distances, diameters of the Earth, the numbers 5, 10, 15, 20. So as it's bouncing around a great distance, many tens of thousands of miles. And the more it gets perturbed, the more it bounces around, the more seismic activity we start to see on Earth. We're looking down on Earth from the North Pole, and all of these things going around the planet are satellites, which are kept track of. So looking down on the North Pole, this is out in front of the planet. This would be on either side. And that's the magnetic field around the Earth that's being compressed in and bouncing around. And when I showed it last night, I told everybody, this is again a sign that we're probably going to be seeing a seismic increase that takes place. Well, here we are, and we certainly have a seismic increase taking place now. And the news across all the world is now reporting at least 20 dead, 165 injured, after tsunami hits in Indonesia, beaches of Sumatra and Java, following volcanic eruption, and that volcanic eruption is at Mount Krakatau. It'll be interesting to see what we ultimately come out with. Oh, wait. Footage of the volcano in Indonesia, what is followed by a deadly tsunami. a day after it has exploded. So this was yesterday? That's what it says. Now, I don't know if that's accurate. Again, when you see videos on Twitter, you do have to somewhat look at them skeptically. It looks a little grainy. Again, now you could get low-quality cell phone video, but most people have high quality at this point. Let's just, again, take that for what it is. That could be, but we'll keep going and see if there's anything else. Lots of shots of the damage. Look at the damage that was caused to these cars and houses and in restaurants and so forth. 20 people killed. That means a lot of people were caught off guard. Let's hit play on this.
Hello, my friends. Evolution.
Okay, well, let's... Wait. We've got major shaking going on there, first of all, from not from a wave. Look at the seismic. Hold on. Let's get this in a full screen. So we're seeing the electrical lines and the trees moving, which itself is a sign that that's not from wind, per se, guys. Now here comes the tsunami. It's coming up and over. People not expecting that, I'm sure. How big was it? Wow. Immediately in. Well, that's at least a 15, 20 foot wave when it comes in. And then it's going up to the building tops immediately. Let's carry on. Okay, this person's covering it as well. That's got to be a different shot. That can't be the shot of the blast. That's just too pretty. Okay, well, again, I appreciate anybody who's covering this. I just want to show what's going on. So we got major damage going across the area. There's no doubt about it. And widespread tsunami damage from a wave generated from the blast, which came, one more time, from right here at Mount Krakatau, which itself is located in the straits between Sumatra and Java. This is Java, and this is Sumatra. You may have heard of Java and Sumatra before when you buy your coffee beans. So we get different types of coffees grown over here, and that's no exaggeration. That's where it comes from. Here we are, Krakatau, right in the middle. Son of Krakatoa, which blew apart 150 years ago, and the blast heard around the world. No seismic activity related with this reported by the Western agencies, but I think that's going to change. They'll probably populate an earthquake on here once all the hubbub has died down on the tsunami. So again, no reason in panicking the world while reporting a large earthquake here when they're already dealing with the aftermath of the event. But eventually they're going to have to put a seismic event on this. No doubt about that. We're dealing with a series of deep earthquakes down below the plate, starting over here where our letter D is, which stands for deep earthquakes. And we go over here where our other letter D is. Well, that's in Indonesia. And they're all being hit by deep earthquakes. Deep earthquakes equal shallower, larger movement that spreads out and away from the deep events. So in between here, for instance, we had a 45,000-foot high blast this past week at Manam Volcano. Now, over here to the west of it, we get a 55,000-foot high blast right where the rings overlap at our fulcrum point. I don't think we're done yet. I think we're going to see other activity in the next few days. Going up towards Japan, big open silent zone across, well, the distance, what is that? That's about the distance of the United States. But turn in a diagonal way. So we're talking about 2,000 miles of open space with no earthquakes at all in the last 2-3 days. Japan is normally seismically prone. You would expect fours at least to strike in a few days' time. So you don't get anything, and then you have multiple volcanic blasts happening all around the region. It means the areas where there are open silent zones and no earthquakes right now, and the areas where the rings overlap, look where all the rings overlap here in Indonesia, for instance. You see where the pink rings overlap with the white rings and they all center in right here? That's no coincidence. That middle point's coming under stress. We just had a 55,000-foot high blast and tsunami here. What do you think's happening in the other areas surrounding this location going out towards Japan and over towards Europe? I can tell you this. Nepal has been filled in with a new 4. Africa was hit last night. New spread of activity in 6s filling in between our deep quakes. And we go over here at South America. I could get into a whole separate video on what's going on in South America, in the United States even. I mean, Texas, even the East Coast was hit last night. up here in Massachusetts, right at the border of New Hampshire and Massachusetts. West Coast is starting to move with threes, but that's pretty low. So we're going to compensate over here. All here is going to compensate for what's going on over here. Let's go consult the Volcanic Ash Advisory Center again and just see what's going on there. Krakatau still has its text alert warning from the Darwin Volcanic Ash Advisory Center. 55,000 foot high observed moving to the southwest. So it's moving to the ash cloud is moving in this direction. Out to sea. I guess that would be the only good... Oh, it's blowing out towards, well, west of Christmas Island. How ironic. So we're going right out here to the southwest and blowing this way. That's good news. So a 55,000 foot eye blast is nothing to scoff at, and to have it blow southwest is the best news I think we can get out of that. Krakatau was building up to this. We saw a series of smaller blasts. Look, 6,000, 060, that's 6,000 foot high. That's normal for the volcano. Now, I'd like to remind everybody one more time, you can come over to my YouTube channel and click on videos and then go back through, find my forecast from 6 days ago. Let me see. Global earthquake forecast from the 17th. And look, the thumbnail is me warning Sumatra, Indonesia. And I can bring it in. It's where we told everybody to watch. And here we are in the video. Let me just hit play. Hold on. Yeah, that's 48 hours where our two earthquakes overlap. That goes into Sumatra, West Java. So how big do I think it's going to go? I think upper 6 to lower 7, based upon all the other activity that's going on. You got to remember, Sopiutan volcano started to erupt, as well as Ibu and Dukono. We have a 45,000 foot high blast here. And up to the north, multiple going in Japan, with the volcanoes here basically stopping, and an earthquake near 6 off the western coast of Australia. For my Aussie viewers, we'll talk about that in a moment as well, what that's going to mean for you, since I didn't really cover it in tonight's update. I already did a video on it twice today, so didn't figure I'd cover it again in tonight's update. So with all this activity going on over here, leads me to think that Indonesia is primed and ready for an upper 6 to near 7 over at Sumatra, where our two rings overlap, which coincidentally or not is where Mount Krakatau was erupting almost every day for months and then basically has stopped. Same for Mount Sinabung and Mount Agung. So none of the volcanoes are erupting in western Indonesia, and that's a change. I would like to see one of those volcanoes start to erupt. That would mean at least a release of pressure. But right now, earthquake threat as we go up to the... Okay, I mean, there you go. That's my warning from the 17th. And the spot where the rings overlap is the middle fulcrum point. And I even brought up Mount Krakatau and brought up how it normally erupts and with small eruptions, and that it had stopped by Sunday night when I issued my forecast. Krakatau wasn't erupting. Nothing was across Indonesia. That's why I said, something's building here. They were all erupting, and then they just suddenly stopped, and there were no earthquakes as well. So, now it's been filled in with quakes and a large blast. The largest blast I think we've seen in years anywhere around here. Maybe even, you could even say, it is the largest blast in years for the planet, because it's caused a tsunami, scores of people to be killed by a wave, and hundreds of people injured. So it is the largest blast. I mean, we could also say there was that 55,000 foot high stratospheric blast that happened a couple months ago. But other than that, I mean, we don't normally see blasts this big, this devastating with wave action, and especially of all places, Krakatau, or the son of Krakatoa. So one more time, let's go in and see if we have any new videos being posted. So the last 2 hours, what's this? Whoa. That's not it. That's not a 50,000 foot high blast. That's what we call fake news. Okay, well, let's keep going. See if we have any other information coming out of the area. apocalyptic scenes in Indonesia. Where? Uh-oh. Well, that does look somewhat accurate, actually, guys. So this does look like it's recent from The Guardian. Getting swept away. Okay, well, here we are, guys. Let me take you back over and show you what's going on in the West Pacific. The largest blast in years, tsunami, and no earthquake reported yet. But again, I think they're going to wait until all the tsunami news is down, and then they'll tell everybody, look, here's the seismic event related with that. But they won't populate it on the same day. That would alarm everybody. Everybody would think it's a new earthquake popping off if they throw an earthquake on here now. And that's the last thing anybody needs, is their earthquake app going off, notifying them of a, you know, 7.0 earthquake. That, what if they did? That would, again, it would scare everybody. They would think a new earthquake struck, even if it's just them reporting the many-hour-old now event. Now, it's a couple hours since it's happened, so now I think we can pretty much guess that the wave activity is over, and it is a guess because there could also be undersea landslides still associated with this. It could happen. Things, you know, teetering on the edge of collapse that could further collapse if any more seismic activity comes into the area. This is the spot we were watching, and that is the spot that was hit. Spot on, where the two rings overlap. And don't forget, we're still dealing with the aftermath of the 7.4 up here in the North Pacific, and my people in Alaska are still dealing with the aftermath of the 7 up in Anchorage. So it's a lot of activity that's going on right now, I guess the whole point of that is. Let me stress to all of you who are listening, you need to have an emergency plan. And if you live along the ocean, you already know this, but you need to have a quick exit plan to get to higher ground within minutes of something happening, whether it's a large earthquake or other. And I say other because a volcanic blast or an undersea landslide can also cause these same type of wave events locally. The good news is this is not spreading out across the entire Pacific. The bad news is scores of people killed, or at least dozens of people killed, and hundreds of people injured so far. I'm going to go ahead and save this as a video for everybody to watch back in the future. First of all, it's an example of me warning an area and it getting hit with a tsunami in the same week. Secondly, it's the biggest eruption in years for Mount Krakatau. Mount Krakatau, one of the famous volcanoes of the world. And it's also a good reminder to everybody to have a plan and be prepared. Now, I'm not going to lecture you. I'm just going to tell you to develop an emergency plan. That means take shelter, basically, from an earthquake. And if you live along the oceans, you need to have an exit plan and quick escape plan. I know, it's the last thing you need to deal with, but you chose to live along the ocean at a low-lying level if you live there. So you can make those plans. I'm just reminding you. And finally, I'm going to tell you your emergency kit should have all the basics in it that you need to survive for at least a few days on your own. Don't wait for Big Brother, the government, to come take care of you. Otherwise, you might be waiting a very long time. They may never come. Or you might get whisked off away to some gymnasium or government facility somewhere. I would suggest being self-sufficient and having a plan and knowing where to go and what to do ahead of time. And the emergency kit is usually made up of stuff you have in your house already, or you're supposed to. You're supposed to have a first aid kit. You're supposed to have an extra set of keys for your house or car. You're supposed to have an insurance card and an ID and an extra one or a copy of it as well. Maybe even your birth certificate and important documents. You should have that stuff in a bag and have it ready to go with a flashlight, batteries, just basic stuff. Change of clothes, set of shoes, food and water for a day or two in case you're caught outside for a little while. And make sure it's seasonal specific. I mean, you might live in the tropics where it's warm all year round, but you might live in the northern hemisphere where it's getting cold and you might get displaced outside. So make sure you're seasonal specific on your emergency kit and make sure you know what to do when an earthquake strikes and make sure you have an evacuation plan if you live near an ocean. These are basic things, but I'm just reminding you to do it because now is the time to have the plan and dust it off and be ready. We're in December. We're 3 weeks in. and we're dealing with 4 7.0 earthquakes in the last 3 weeks, and now two different near 50,000 foot high blast, 45,000 at one volcano, Manam, and 55,000 foot high blast with tsunami and hundreds injured and dozens killed. I'm going to save it as a video over on YouTube. We'll premiere it back in just a little bit. One more time, thanks to everybody on Twitter for doing their part to post the information and get it out to the world. If you could, please share the information from my channel as well, and I will be back on if anything else happens. All right? So peace out, word up, and much love to all of you. And we'll see you back here if anything else goes down. And yes, that's a full moon up in the upper right-hand corner, shining down on our lake. That's not the sun.